So now, here we go. A big round of applause for Milad and Simon.
Yeah. Thank you. Milad and Simon,
everybody. Wow, how about that? That's fucking awesome.
So, we need to talk a little bit first about what the hell was going on there. So, no, don't take your rings off, because they're the shiny rings. The shiny things, did you see? Did you notice these lovely shiny rings here? Tell me first about the bracelets and the rings and what they were doing.
I just like jewellery, you know.
Yeah.
This is kind of music making jewellery. It's special.
These are EMG sensors, so they sense my muscle data. They're sending triggers to Max Patch, which triggers loads of grains. And then, I mean, otherwise it's just like a theremin. I've got kind of pitch on here, grain triggering on there. And so I imagine this 3D world of grains around me. I'm exploring with this hand where the grains are. So there'll be a sound there, a different sound there. So I'm just playing through that. And these are switching kind of presets of how the grain is playing. And there's a bit of stuff on there as well. Yeah.
Amazing. Well, what was it you were kind of playing around with the sounds that were going on there as well?
So basically, I mean, with the setup that we've got is similar in the sense that we both work with granulation and concatenative synthesis. What I was doing was mostly focusing on form and drones, and also I was using quite a lot of sort of field recording that I didn't record myself, because I'm sure you've probably seen on the news about things that are happening in my home country of Iran, where now a revolution is ongoing, so I couldn't really bring myself.
So that's where the chanting and the political kind of stuff was coming from. Brilliant.
In terms of technical setup, I mean, it was very similar to what Simon is doing, with the main difference that I use a 2D display and sort of use faders and knobs to basically traverse through my grains. I couldn't really bring myself to doing anything else creatively when this stuff is happening in my country and people are dying. That's all I could do.
Big respect to you for that. And so, just technically for me as a layperson, just explain grains to me, because that's a new kind of phrase, and I've done a lot of these nights, but I've not heard that phrase before. What does that mean?
So, if you take a sound file, which I'm sure you all know, and you cut it into really small slices, you can do a lot with them in terms of time stretching and pitch shifting that don't affect the length or the pitch. Either they're interdependent, essentially. And it just allows, as I say, it allows me to. There's some clever software that some other people wrote, shout out to Flucoma, where you analyze all your sound files, maybe like on your Deluge, and it decides this sort of sound goes up here, this sort of sound goes up here, this sort of sound goes down here, but it cuts it into really small slices, and then it gives you something to play with. So you can see, I think Milad's thing is probably better. Like that's like a 2D. Sort of, so all his grains.
And what we're seeing here is a kind of diagram of those different sounds.
Yes.
Yeah.
So it's scattered plots.
If any of you, after we finish, if you want to come and have a look, quick look at the laptop, that would be absolutely fine. Guys, thank you so much.
Thank you.
It's absolutely brilliant. So different. Again, yeah, big round of applause.